confusing all like the whole way there, so.
Gotta get my coffee. Did you get yours, Evan?
Give me what?
Coffee.
Water?
Yeah.
Lake Monroe, ready to hit the water with Tony Stewart and Leah Pruitt on the Supra SL, SA, and SE.
Females are normally intimidated by it. The role we do is the polar opposite of that all the time. I always drive the trailer and you always...
We also have two other boats to put on as well. Or take off.
Just get in the boat.
No, do you...
Get your in the boat.
You know what? I'm not allowed to drive for it anyway. It's all right. I'll take that. I'll take this fine piece of...
Rapperism.
Found on the road dead machinery.
Apparently she didn't understand that she met first on race day.
That's pretty slick.
That was slick.
Now get your in the boat, princess.
Oh my god. She's just afraid to back it out. It's fine, we'll take you.
She's always talking.
But if you can just shut it off yourself also.
So it's auto on with the ignition?
Yep.
On? Okay, that's nice.
So here it's gonna show you ballast percentage, pitch and roll, and then surf left or right. When you look here, you're
pitch
gonna see...
Pitch and roll, sorry.
Pitch and roll is the bow rise of the boat, how it lies left or right in the water. So that's your surf screen and your speed are up here, which you can adjust with this tab to go up and down. So if you need to adjust while you're surfing, just a little bit, you can do that.
So speed's on the right.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And then it's, mm-hmm. Yep. And then your zero off is also going to be here. So you can adjust it there. So like forward.
Move it everywhere.
Back, up and down. And then your lights tab is also here. You can just do this auto adjuster. And when you slow down, the sound's going to get lower. So when you speed up, the sound's going to get higher.
Like with surfing. So as soon as you back out of the throttle, yep. It should be based on. So the intensity is really how much it brings it down or how much it brings it up.
Yep. Absolutely.
Especially if you eventually know how to do some stuff, there's a lot of room. Very user friendly. That would be the word. Do you come with me?
Two feet. One.
So. Now when you look at the steering wheel, it's different, right? It's more of like that racing style steering wheel.
Right.
With like the hard buttons, not really the soft touch ones. But you see like these switches here are gone.
Right.
But they're back here. They're like paddle shifters.
What'd you go from on the tabs?
So, the left surf tab was set at 85, and I bumped it to like 65 just to show like how much it would change. And then the left surf tab was 95 when it was like clean. And then I did it like to 70 to where the SA was. And that's where you saw like that washed out portion of it.
Yeah. Okay. So. Of the day started off with the SA, which I completely loved, and then got on the SL, which I fell in love with a little bit of extra room. And now that we're here on the SE, we have all this room. But I think what I love the most right now is the familiarity that I have with the cluster and with all of the adjustments and volumes and speed and tabs and throttle. Everything is so user friendly at this moment. It's really just about how much room would you like, where would you like your ergonomics to be, your color pickout. I'm already completely more than sold on how user-friendly this is. I feel like I've been literally driving a Supra and riding behind a Supra my whole life, and it's only been a couple of hours. So I'm stoked. I'm afraid I'm gonna fall in love with this one, as I did with the other two. But that's what this is about, is having a good time and really picking out how much deluxe do we want to get? How much room do we want? Because I surfed farther back today on the SL than I've ever been, and wider. I didn't even know that that was a thing, to go back and go out and come back in, which made me truly believe that I might have the capabilities to someday turn some tricks. I don't know. But today has been amazing. We're about to go out and just, you know, eat up this for everything that it's worth and have an amazing time. This is what happens when Evan forgets his surf rope again.
Much bigger penalty when you don't have a rope if you fall in.
Definitely a taller wave.
Yeah.
Which is awesome.
So when you think of just waves right now, like, what's your kind of wave preference? SAS, LSE?
Man, right now I'm thinking, I love the SE, but I feel like for the SL, for what I want to do, which is going to be learning more tricks and more maneuverability,
absolutely.
I feel like that's going to be the one for me. That experience right there was amazing. I was like, it was a little bit intimidating. It was so big, which is awesome. So it's just a really preference on what type of wave that you want. I truly enjoyed how much real estate I had behind the SL.
Yeah.
And I was trying to find it here, and I didn't get there yet.
Yep.
So maybe on this one, I'll see what type of, how much room I have back there. If I don't mess it up.
And we can adjust that tab to kind of lengthen that wave out, give you more room if you want. So if you like the size of the wave, the way it pushes you, like, we'll keep it that way.
I love the push. I could be way back there and there was still a ton of push.
Okay.
And like even on the curl over too, you could almost like barrel roll that as well.
Yeah,
I think like on this one, I'm just going to try and stay up longer and feel the wave down below and see how much push I can get all the way back and not try and do anything fancy. Just literally ride the wave.
Okay.
I wasn't able to learn, I don't think, any of, there was no tolerance in anything I've ridden before that. This has got all the room you could ever dream. If you just want to go out there and cruise and carve, and then you want to go out there and try stuff, that is the place to do it.
So I said I asked you that question, a run too early, set too early. So now after that run, being on the wave, and what you've just said, like, has your mind changed?
Man, I feel like it's when somebody asks you, like, if you have kids, like, which kid do you love better? And you're like, I don't love one more than the other. I just love them differently.
Yeah, absolutely.
Like, I love the SL and the S8 and the SE. I think ultimately what stands out the most is the more room. And if you've got more people, if you've got big families and you can take a bunch of people out. I mean, we're not packed today. And that thing was ginormous, tall, long. Man, still for me, I do still think that the SL delivers everything that I need. And I don't have that many friends, so if it's just like 5, 6, 7, 8 of us, like, we're gonna feel nice and cozy and be perfect. I ride in the SE, I'll feel like, man, I've gotta fill it up, but that was amazing. Like, that literally makes me want to surf every day and, like, bring back my joy and passion for surfing, like the pro wake style, like the lifestyle, everything about it is what I just got to experience. So
absolutely. Yeah. That is the goal. So I'm glad you got to experience it.
Me too. That was way rad. Wow. Thank you guys. That was like, you made the decision way easy on Super, but way hard on which one?